I hate surprises.
Yeah?
Yes.
You didn't mind when I surprised you with my promotion?
Well, that wasn't a surprise. That was earned by my genius husband.
Good answer by my genius wife.
Well, see, I thought you only liked me for my body.
I do like you for your body.
What are we doing?
Surprise.
I don't understand. What is it?
The house?
Yes. Yes, I can see that. Thank you.
Also known as a home, sanctuary, dwelling.
Yeah.
Or if you like, you could just call it ours.
Ours?
Mm-hmm.
Where would we get the money? I mean, how do we get into something like this?
Oh, I don't know. Maybe with the key?
Oh, my God.
Oh, my God. Are you kidding me?
Classic. 1920s, wood frame, 3-bedroom, 1.5-bath. And the old owners even left us a brand new swing set out back.
Oh, well, I think I'm a little big for swing sets.
Maybe you have to fill out those spare rooms sometime soon, right?
Thank you.
Yeah, I love you.
I love you too. Let's go home.
Today, baby, it was just an overnight trip.
Why couldn't he take us?
Because it was work and we couldn't go. But how about a good morning, Mommy? Nice to see you.
Good morning, Mommy.
Mom, you gotta get dressed.
Sweetie, we got plenty of time.
We're gonna be late for school.
Oh, no. We're not gonna be late for school. Better get going or we'll be late for school.
Bridget, are you okay with your spelling words?
Yes, Mom.
Hey, don't forget your lunches. I got it? Come on, got it. Give me a kiss. Bye.
Come on, Megan. I am.
idea where this week went.
God, I wish you were here. I'm having the hardest time trying to pick out my dress for tonight. What about you guys? You have any big plans for the weekend?
What, besides jetting off to Acapulco? No.
Yeah, right. Okay, I gotta go. I gotta figure out what I'm doing with my life right now.
Oh, yeah? What's his name?
His name? Well, the name is really bad. It's Harry.
But you never know. He could be the one.
Bye.
You have one new message. First new message.
Linda, listen. I need to tell you something. I meant what I said in front of the girls the other night, and I just want you to know that. And to please remember it. Damn it. Someone's calling. Hold on. Is that you?
End of messages.
If you'll leave a message, I'll get back to you as soon as possible.
Hey, it's me. Got your message. I don't know when you left it, but just call me when you get mine. Okay? Bye.
Mrs. Hansen?
Yes?
Linda Hansen?
Uh-huh.
I'm Sheriff Riley.
Yes?
I'm sorry to tell you this. Your husband, Jim?
Yeah?
Was in a car accident. He died on the scene.
When?
Yesterday.
No. No, it's impossible because I just heard his voice on the answering machine, so.
Well, I'm sorry, ma'am. We couldn't get to you any sooner. The other driver was in a truck. Semi. Pretty certain it was instantaneous. Jackknife. Mile marker 220. Truck driver was killed as well. Your husband? Ma'am, is there anything that I can do?
Ma'am?
Mrs. Hansen?
Ma'am,
is there anything that I can do? Can I call someone for you? Let me leave you my car. Okay, if you have any questions, you just call me.
Yeah?
Yeah. He's had a very bad accident.
What kind of accident?
When's he coming home? Is he okay?
No, baby's not.
Impressed. You guys got this far all by yourself?
Yeah.
That's really amazing.
Hey, it's Annie. Leave a message at the beep, and I promise I'll get right back to you.
Hey, Annie, it's me. Could you please call me as soon as you get this message? Thank you.
You girls are doing so great.
Daddy's better at puzzles.
He was going to help us.
I should say goodnight.
No, don't do that. They just fell asleep. Leave it. I was thinking about everything we need to get done. Tomorrow we should probably start looking into funeral arrangements. And then, just see where you are in terms of insurance.
I'm not ready for that, Mom.
Nobody's ready for any of this, dear. But you'll be surprised at how strong you're going to be. You know, when I lost your dad,
I can't stop thinking about our serving platter.
What serving platter?
You know, the big one on the top shelf, the one that his folks gave us. I can't reach that. Jim does that for me.
Well, nobody expects you to get everything done in the first few days, dear. I'm pretty tired. I'm gonna go lie down in the den. I'll get some sheets out of the closet. I'll be right up here if you need me, dear.
Thank you.
Mom? Mom?
What's wrong?
I don't know. I just had the strangest dream.
What? What is it?
Make it attention.
You know, is that a good way to start the day? How about good morning, Mommy?
Good morning.
Good morning.
All
right, I gotta get going to the Monday morning meeting. Plenty of hugs for everybody. All right, I gotta get going. Into that. Train this new assistant manager. Pack their lunches. Ready to go. Are you okay to take them to school? You girls have fun at school now.
Bye, okay.
Bye, Daddy.
See you, honey.
You okay with your spelling words, Reg?
Yes.
Hey, you guys, don't forget your lunch.
Come on, Megan, get out of the car.
I'm coming.
That was quite a stop there.
Yeah, I just, I was totally... Yeah, I got comp... I was totally just distracted.
Let's just take it a little easy out there, huh?
Sure.
We don't want anyone getting hurt now, do we?
I'm trying to figure out, should I call him? I mean, I really feel like I want to call him, but then it's kind of like, I think that's breaking the rules. I think it's better if I just wait. What?
Did we talk yesterday?
Yeah, we talk every day.
No, I mean, did I leave you a message?
I don't think so. Why? Wait a minute, hang on. I'm the one with the crisis, okay? Are you sure you're all right?
Yeah.
Everything's cool with you and Jim?
Yeah, everything's exactly the same.
How was everybody's day?
It was okay. Kind of boring. Yeah, kind of boring.
Boring, huh?
Jim? Jim? Jim?
Get some rest.
What's going on?
Hey,
how you feeling? Why don't you go upstairs and let's get some clothes on? No, you want to go upstairs and get dressed?
Where are the girls?
Girls are fine, dear.
Those girls are fine, honey. Don't worry about the girls.
This isn't right.
What is it?
No, everything's fine. Do you need to go upstairs and get more sleep?
No. I don't need any more sleep, and I don't need to wake up either.
Everything's gonna be fine.
No, Mother, everything is not fine. Okay. Something is really, really wrong.
Okay.
He's not dead.
Baby. Hey.
Hi.
Oh,
sorry I wasn't awake when you guys got up.
Grandma said we had to let you sleep.
No, baby, you can always wake me up.
What's your sister doing?
Swinging.
Yeah.
I think she's sad.
We're all a little sad right now. Baby.
Oh my God.
Oh my God, baby.
Baby, what happened to your face? Baby, talk to me. How did you get these cuts? Who did this to you, baby?
Dude, what?
The cuts on your face.
There's no cuts, Mommy.
What are you talking about?
She's perfect. Like a beautiful princess.
Oh, God, come here. Come here, just hold on to me. It's gonna be okay. It's gonna be okay, come here. It's gonna be all right. Everything's gonna be all right. Everything's gonna be all right.
Mommy?
Yeah?
What was it like when Daddy died?
I don't know, baby. I wasn't there.
So how did you know he died then?
What if this is a mistake?
What do you mean, a mistake?
People just don't die one day and are okay the next day, that's all.
It's not a mistake, Jim's...
Oh, okay, Mom, did you see inside the casket?
No, I didn't see
okay,
there, but
well,
it does...
Something is seriously fucked up with this situation.
Linda, we need to go in the church now. Mm-hmm. Come on,
no,
dear.
No, you need to take the kids inside.
Well, why don't you come
just
inside
just take the
with
kids
this...
inside.
Go ahead with the kids. Linda?
Hello, Mrs. Hanson. Oh, I just want you to know that everything's on schedule.
I need for you to open up the casket.
Oh, no. I don't think that would be a very good idea.
Open
not
up the casket, goddammit.
Your wishes.
Open it up. Open it, Mrs. Hanson.
What? I beg you to let this go.
Don't do this to me.
Mrs. Hanson,
what?
I have to warn
what?
You. There was a problem with
what
the body.
Kind of problem?
They didn't want to tell you the way he died. They didn't.
What about the way he died?
There was a deep cut, a severing.
What kind of severing?
Jim left this world a beloved person. His friends spoke about his kindness, his laugh, his graciousness, his helpfulness and consideration to everyone around him. But his greatest devotion was to his family, his girls, as he liked to refer to them, his lovely wife, Linda, precious daughters, Megan and Bridget.
What? Who's that?
And what better tribute is there to any man?
Oh, her.
than the reflection of his own love in the heart of any man who left behind. And so, dear friend,
Linda,
it's okay.
Let us pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done.
No, please wait. Wait.
I'm stop. Sorry.
How do you know my husband?
I just thought that after we talked.
We talk.
We had yesterday.
Yesterday? I...
You don't remember?
No. I've never met you before in my life.
I'm just gonna go, okay?
Please talk to me.
You have all my sympathies and your girls,
who are you? Please, don't... Hey, why don't you guys go downstairs and visit with Grandma and Aunt Annie?
No.
I'm sure it'd be fun.
What are you looking for, Mommy?
Mommy needs someone to talk to, baby.
Why don't you talk to us?
Baby, I love talking to you, but this is grown-up talk, and Mommy needs some help, okay? Come on, baby, please go downstairs. Thank you, baby. Thank you. It's okay. Physician.
Do you guys want some tea or coffee or anything? Can I get you something?
Maybe we ought to think about getting the girls to sleep, huh?
Oh, yeah.
It's been a long couple of days.
Yes, it has.
All right, girls. Come on with Auntie Annie. We're gonna go upstairs and we'll get your jammies on, okay? Then I'll read you a story. Yeah?
Hello, Linda.
Hello.
I'm Dr. Roth, remember?
No, I
Annie.
Okay, girls, let's go upstairs.
Let's go back
to Mom and get our jammies on. It's coming.
Please don't be angry. Please. Please don't be angry with us.
Wait a second. Annie, what are you doing?
Linda, your family worry about you. Your family cares about you.
What are you doing? Mom, what are you doing? Annie,
what else could we do?
What? Just tell us what happened to Bridget's face.
Mom, I don't know what happened to Bridget's face.
Would you see that's what I mean?
What happened?
Mom, I would never do anything to harm my child. Get away from me.
Her husband was in a fatal car crash on Wednesday. I told her about it on Thursday.
Whoa. Hold on.
Wednesday? That's strange. She showed up in my office on Tuesday, claiming he was already dead or gone again. She said he was going to die before the accident?
Yeah. Are you sure it was an accident?
Please don't do this. Please just let me go home to my girls.
We have time to talk about that
tomorrow. Please don't do this. Please don't do this. You're okay.
Come on, Linda, you're gonna get yourself soaked.
Just give me a minute. Just one more minute.
I can hear your heart beating and it feels so good.
Hold on. Hey, hold on. Everything's gonna be fine. Come on.
I promise.
What is it, honey? Tell me what's going on.
I don't even know how to explain it. You're so beautiful. Do you know that?
Mm-hmm.
You are beautiful. You're both beautiful. Oh. All right, babe, listen to me. I need for you to be very, very careful today, okay? No playing at recess. I don't want you running around, okay? Just promise.
Ma'am, you're holding
sit
up the
quiet.
Line.
Promise me.
Ma'am.
Okay? Just give me a second. Just promise me. Promise?
Okay. I promise.
Hey, baby, you're gonna promise me too, okay?
All right.
Good girl. Okay. There you go. You guys be good.
Ma'am, come on.
Please.
You've got Mrs. Lynn at 3, and then you're free until 5.
Yeah, that's right. So keep that open for me.
Okay.
Who's this?
Mrs. Stevenson.
Steven. Can I help you?
I'm Linda Hansen.
Hello, Linda. I'm Dr. Roth.
Do you know me?
Should I?
I wake up, and he's dead. I wake up, and he's alive. Different things around me all the time that I can't explain. Things that I've done. People talking to me. People who know me, but I have never met.
People like me?
Yes.
Seems a little complicated.
Tell me about it.
What about the lithium bottle?
I don't know. It's I don't know. I misplaced it somewhere. I don't know.
Hmm?
Look, I can't explain it, but I thought if somebody was trying to
drug you?
Mm-hmm.
Why and who?
I don't know. You tell me.
I didn't prescribe it.
But your name was on the bottle. Why do you think I came here?
To get some help. Obviously, you're dealing with some inconsistencies.
Oh, yeah. I wake up every morning to find my husband has died again. I think that goes just a little beyond inconsistent.
How do you feel during the times he's dead?
What?
I mean, what kind of emotions run through you? Is it sorrow, resentment, relief?
What are you saying?
Well, it's a pretty common daydream to imagine people being dead.
I'm not daydreaming, okay? I wake up and he is dead.
Except for today. Do you have any history of mental illness in your family?
No.
What about yourself? Any episodes of psychosis? Memory loss? Judgment lapses?
I don't want him dead. It was a car accident.
Well, there's no crime imagining something.
I'm not imagining it. He's dead.
Well, it is a little odd that the prescription was for lithium.
Why?
Because that's probably the best thing for you right now. It'll help you cope. Do you think you can make it in to see me here tomorrow?
Hey, Bob. Is Jim here?
Yeah. How come you don't come by and see us anymore?
Honey.
I need to talk to you.
What is it? What's going on?
I know I've been acting strange, but there's something wrong. There's something very wrong.
What is it, the girls?
No. They're fine, at least for now. Can we just go somewhere? Just us. Let's just take the girls. Let's go.
I can't go anywhere.
Please,
I have to work.
Please, I really need you. Can you just...
I need to go to this sales meeting.
Excuse me. Jim, we're waiting for you. I'm sorry. Who are you? I'm Claire Francis. You must be Jim's wife.
Yeah,
Linda. I've seen your pictures. It's nice to meet you.
Mm. Claire's our new assistant manager.
Your husband's been really helpful the last few weeks.
Guys, we're starting.
Excuse me.
I can talk about this later.
Thank you.
going through the glass door.
Any allergies?
She's
do we know about?
Codeine.
Okay, let's put her in 14, please. Ma'am, I'm going to need you way out here. No, ma'am, we'll take care of her. Everything's going to be fine.
It's going to be okay, baby.
Is she okay?
Yeah, she just, they just took her in. They just took her in.
You all right?
Yeah. Huh? She was running. I had to get the laundry, and she just went through the glass window.
What are you doing, Mommy?
We are gonna forget about mirrors for a while.
Until you feel a little better.
Aren't you gonna have ugly scars forever?
I don't want any talk about scars.
Alright.
Because as far as I'm concerned, there are no scars. I don't care what anyone tells you, okay? You understand? Because you're beautiful.
Like a princess.
I thought you were gonna put up stickers.
I did. I don't know, maybe. Maybe I thought I did.
Christ, Lynn.
What are you blaming me for this, though?
I've asked your mother to come and stay while I'm gone.
What? Why?
Just to help, you know?
I don't need any
help.
Help
take care of the kids.
I don't need any help.
Look, you can take a break, you know, some time to yourself.
For what? Time to myself for what? What, so I stop acting like a crazy person?
What are you talking about? I never...
You are not separating me from my kids. I'm a good mom.
Except for today.
Meet Dr. Roth on Tuesday, and I am. Oh, commit. Saturday. Please don't do this. Dr. Roth. Bridget's cuts happen on.
Mommy?
Tuesday. Friday and Sunday are still open, and Wednesday.
What's she doing?
Jim, don't go on this trip, please.
I have to. I waited a year for this interview. Besides, it could be good for us, you know? Take a break from each other.
Well, it might be a bigger break than you bargained for. What if something happens to you?
Something could happen to me on my way home from work. Should I stop working?
You want me to beg? I will beg. Please, just don't go. You have children and you have a family.
Why are you saying that? You think I've forgotten that?
No, I haven't.
Because I haven't.
I realize that. I didn't say that you forgot. Just listen to me.
Look, you just...
No,
just stop it. Stop it.
Just do me one favor. If tomorrow's Wednesday, just please wake me up before you leave.
If tomorrow's Wednesday.
I know it sounds crazy. Just please wake me up, okay?
Jesus.
Promise me.
I promise.
Okay.
Okay.
Yes, bed. It's just awful.
Mom. That's right. You stayed over. It stayed over.
Did you forget I was here?
No. I remember. I remember now. So that would be Friday morning.
You had the shock of your life yesterday.
Tell me about it. Something we should be talking about. Something involving my husband. I told you. I think you just did. He was gonna cheat on me.
Minute. How do you know? How did you find out?
I talked to her. She told me everything.
When?
Today.
Oh, and I'm sorry. Are you still in shock?
No. Mm-hmm. Well, I passed up shock a couple days ago.
The whole thing is bad. The accident, the other woman, it's a mess.
I don't know if it's so bad. You know, maybe it was supposed to happen.
What do you mean?
Even though he didn't do anything yet, the damage that it would have caused us, the girls, maybe it was enough that he was going to.
Are you listening to what you're saying?
We were roommates, Annie. We were roommates, two girls, and my roommate was a liar.
Thank you.
As far as your mortgage and your daughter's education, it should all be taken care of. And with the annuity Jim left, you should be pretty much set income-wise, so.
You know, Linda, I have to tell you, the timing in all this.
Timing? What do you mean, timing?
Jim stopped in to see me Wednesday morning, right before his trip.
Wednesday?
Yeah. And he seemed very anxious, like he wasn't quite sure of things. And he kept talking about you and the girls, and he said that no matter what happened, he wanted to make sure you're all okay. And then he tripled his death benefits. I mean, it's not a problem. The police reports all confirm it was an accident, so I'll just get this cleared through the main office, and I should have a check for you fairly soon.
Nice view, huh?
Yes, very.
You have a family?
I have two daughters, but,
it's no big deal. It happens to a lot of people. They drive by here just like you did, see the houses by this beautiful lake, and suddenly say to themselves, what a great place to start over. I moved here after my divorce.
Really?
Yeah, it's great. It's like a whole new life.
This moss pink velvet is very nice. I believe I would like that for the showroom. And Mr. Weigel, I'll have to call you back. Thank you.
Hello. I'm Dorothy Quinn.
I know.
Got it. Hi, honey.
Hi, Mom.
One for you.
Oh.
One for you, Mommy.
You're welcome. You know how much I love you, right?
Linda?
Yeah.
I don't want to upset you, but...
What is it, Mom?
I know this is very difficult, but I really do think we need to drive out to the funeral home, dear. I'll go with you.
Oh, it's done.
What?
I've already made all the arrangements.
Oh. Well, when were you thinking of having the...
The funeral is tomorrow. It's all set.
Saturday?
Saturday.
That soon?
Yes, that soon.
Okay, hon.
Hey, Mom.
Mm-hmm.
If I let Jim die, is that the same thing as killing him?
Honey, Jim's already dead. Night, dear.
Girls, can you keep it down, please?
It's Sunday.
All day long.
Hey, why don't you take the girls out for a while? You know, you guys should spend some time together. And you can go have some fun.
Yeah, okay. That's a good idea. You girls want Daddy to make you some pancakes for breakfast?
Yeah!
Hello, Father.
Linda. It's been a long time.
I'm scared, Father.
Dutch trading colony off the coast of Carolina. An hysterical midwife claimed to have walked through the aftermath of a terrible hurricane that hadn't happened yet.
So what happened?
They hung her for being a witch. 2 days later, the entire town was wiped out by a gale force hurricane.
That's awful.
Let's skip ahead to the 20th century. Boston, 1918. At the height of the influenza epidemic, a father told friends he'd been to the future and seen the graves of his 2 small children. He went insane and shot them both to spare them the disease.
Oh my God.
The autopsy showed the children were never infected. He shot himself a week later.
Who are these people? Why did it happen?
You see, history's full of unexplained phenomena. Nobody knows why. Some people thought they suffered from what the ancients called blasphemare absens fides, the dangers of the faithless.
The faithless?
It's the notion that nature abhors a vacuum, even a spiritual one. People who've lost their beliefs, they're like empty vessels, more susceptible to having their lives taken over by forces bigger than themselves.
It's almost like a curse.
Or a miracle.
Yeah, well, I don't believe in miracles.
Every day we're alive can be a miracle.
Well, it doesn't feel that way. Not for me. Something bad is going to happen. I need your help. I need your direction. I need faith.
Faith is just believing in something beyond yourself. Something you can't feel or smell or touch. Like hope or love.
I believe I've let that all go.
Maybe you should try and get it back again, huh?
But if it's too late?
It's never too late to realize what's important in your life, to fight for it.
I don't know what to fight for.
Thank you. History's full of unexplained phenomena.
Bridget! No, Bridget!
Nobody knows why.
Open it up! Open it up! No!
Obviously, you're dealing with some inconsistencies.
Dangers of faith.
I'm Claire Francis. Your husband's been really helpful the last few weeks.
Jim.
How do you feel during the time this day?
You don't want anyone getting hurt now, do we?
If I let Jim die...
It's never too late.
Is that the same thing as killing him?
Inconsistencies.
Is that the same thing as killing him? You guys have a good time?
Yeah. We had a great time.
Good.
Oh, good girls. Night. What's this all about?
Mama said to give you extra hugs.
Extra hugs? Oh, well, how about extra hugs and extra kisses? Now off to bed. Go brush your teeth.
Hey, girls, why don't you tell Daddy how much you love him?
Love you, Daddy.
Me too.
Well, thank you, ladies.
Aren't you going to tell them?
Tell them what?
That you love them. You do love them, don't you?
Of course I do.
Then tell them.
You girls know how much I love you, right? Huh? Right?
I love you more than anything in the whole world.
Mom, too.
Here. Honey, let's go back inside.
How did we get here, Jim? I miss you. I miss us.
Still an us. It's just different now, that's all.
Why? Why is it different?
I don't know why. What did you expect us to be like?
Just the way we used to be.
Take a look at us. We're married, we've got a house, a mortgage. Kids, why do we have to talk about this now? Why can't we just go inside?
Because we're running out of time! Watch out!
that look.
What look?
Like you want to tell me something?
I had a dream you're gonna die.
That was only a dream. Everything's gonna be fine.
Hello.
Annie, Annie, what day is it today?
It's Wednesday. What's the matter?
Girls? Jim!
Oh, shoot. Take the girls to school. We'll be back tomorrow.
Hi, this is Jim Hansen. I can't get your call right now, but if you'll leave a message, I'll get back to you as soon as possible. Thanks for calling.
I should be able to take care of this right away. No problem.
Thanks, Doc.
Got to the room.
It's really nice. I can't wait for you to get here. Jim, something wrong?
Yeah. I'm sorry, I can't do this.
Do what? The interview?
Us.
Jim. Pick up, Jim, pick up.
Hi, you've reached the Hansen residence.
You know what to do.
Listen, Linda. I need to tell you something. I meant what I said in front of the girls the other night, and, well, I want you to know that.
And please remember it.
Damn it, someone's calling, hold on.
Is that you?
Linda?
Jim?
I love you, honey. I need to tell you something.
It's all right. I know about her. I know about Claire.
You do?
Yeah. I have to explain it, but it
Honey, listen. I thought that's what I wanted, but I don't.
I just...
I want to make things better, you know?
Between us.
Whatever it takes.
I see you. I see you. I'm coming up right behind you.
You are?
I'm pulling over.
Thank you.
I can see you, honey.
Oh, no.
Jim, do you love me? Do you trust me?
Of course I do.
Then turn around now.
What? I don't understand.
Turn it around. Baby, you all right?
Jim? Can you hear me? Are you okay? Baby, can you hear me?
Sorry, I dropped the phone.
I love you. Let's go home.
Okay, hold on. I stalled it.
They're
here.
Mm-hmm. Oh, maybe I must have fallen asleep.
The moving truck is here.
I know, I heard. Healing so nicely. Why don't you guys go downstairs? I'll be there in a second, okay?
Okay.
It's just believing in something beyond yourself, like hope or love. It's never too late to realize what's important in your life, to fight for it.